Well, certainly, first of all, the OBOR initiative is a terrific initiative. The fundamental of it is global engagement and inclusion, and that is what we as investors advocate on a global basis. We've been now for 35 years investing not only in Europe, but also in North America, Middle East, and now increasingly Asia. So we do support and endorse all initiatives that do endorse that global engagement. Specifically on the infrastructure front, certainly there are many parts of the world, the GCC being one of them, but also Europe and many parts of Asia, which do need the foundation for their future and evolving economies. Infrastructure is the foundation of any one of those evolving economies, and we look forward alongside many others to be an active participant in that journey for many of these countries.
Okay, if we could focus on where we are now, Asia, and this infrastructure deficit that people have been talking about for years now. One of the big problems has been where the money is going to come from. When you put together all the multilateral institutions, which theoretically fund projects of this nature, huge infrastructure projects, still not enough. The private sector will have to necessarily get involved, which brings in folks like yourselves at Investcorp. But one of the key obstacles has been return on investment. It hasn't been there. Very hard to find bankable deals. Has that changed?
Yeah. So the last 10 years have been a fantastic run in most alternative assets, whether it's private equity, real estate, credit, or capital markets. The expectation is that positive momentum will come sooner or later to some kind of a slowdown. That is the nature of business cycles. When that happens, and all expectations are in the coming year that is likely to be the case, infrastructure returns become somehow a bit more attractive. So in a way, it is a counter-cyclical type of investment. It's one, as you know, infrastructure investing kicks in usually during slower times. So as we plan for the future, as we plan for the next macro cycle, we do believe that infrastructure investing, not just in the GCC, but also in many pockets in Asia and also Europe, will continue to be an attractive area to do so.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.